But for the future, Lamine Yamal already knows that Barcelona are already preparing important contracts when he will turn 18. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Fabrizio Romano here, as always, to keep you posted on the transfer market. And today, important things to share about the history maker, Lamine Yamal. Congrats to Barcelona star born in 2007, who scored with the Spanish national team. But something to say also on his teammate, Balde, and on Sofyan Amrabat, who joined Manchester United on deadline day. Let's jump into it. Together. And so, guys, big day for Spain because a new star is born. We already had that kind of feeling weeks and months ago with Lamine Yamal, this fantastic talent from Barcelona, born in July 2007, and with 16 years old and 57 days, Lamine Yamal becomes the youngest player to ever play with the Spanish national team and to ever score with the Spanish national team with fantastic impact against Georgia. This is very special, guys, because when you have big competition with Spain or with Barcelona, these are fantastic rosters, fantastic squads for Lamine Yamal, with 16 years old, to be part of the squad, to be on the pitch and to make an impact is something really impressive. So congrats to Lamine. But what I wanted to say is that if you follow me, you remember since July that there is already an agreement between Barcelona and Lamine Yamal with his agent, Jorge Mendes, the man who brought João Félix and João Cancelo to Barcelona this summer to extend the contract of Lamine Yamal. So everything is already agreed and completed. Lamine Yamal contract will be valid until June 2026, so a 3-year deal, because this is the obligation, this is the rule. You can't do a 5, 6, 7-year deal for a boy when he's that young. The limit is 3-year deal, but the relationship is excellent, and so officially it's a 3-year extension. But for the future, Lamine Yamal already knows that Barcelona are already preparing important contracts when he will turn 18. But at the moment, everything is under control with a new contract already agreed in July before the pre-season tour for Lamine Yamal. Also, new contract agreed with Alejandro Balde, in this case until 2028, for the fantastic, talented left back. So everything is agreed on that one. But for Balde, I wanted to reveal something to you guys. From what I heard this summer, it was early, it was end of April, beginning of May, so the very early stages of the summer transfer window, Manchester City asked for information about Balde. People into Man City really like Balde, they believe he has a fantastic potential, and so they asked Barcelona about some possibility for Balde, maybe to make a bid, maybe to discuss about a swap deal. But from Barca, the answer was a no, because Balde was never considered as a player on the market. They trust Balde, they want Balde to be part of the project, and his contract is extended until 2028. So two wonderful news for Barcelona, and also for Manchester United to have Sofyan Amrabat in their squad. We know it was a very long negotiation, a very long story with Amrabat waiting for Man United since June. But for Amrabat, it's important to touch on one more point. He rejected some clubs this summer because he was waiting and waiting and waiting for Manchester United. But in July, he had two approaches from England. One was from West Ham and one was from Nottingham Forest. Both clubs tried to sign Amrabat. Amrabat said, no, I prefer to wait till the end for Man United. And it was a risk for Sofyan Amrabat, who wanted to wait till the end. And when an Italian club tried to enter the race in August, the answer from Amrabat was the same. Sorry, I will wait for Manchester United. So really, what Amrabat did to join Man United was something special, not easy to find in modern football, a player who is that obsessed with the club or with a move. Amrabat did it. So he's now at Man United and enjoy this great midfield. And so guys, let me know your thoughts on Lamine Yamal, incredible impact, Alejandro Balde, but also Sofyan Amrabat. I wait for your comments. See, as always, remember to like this video, turn on the notification bell, subscribe to the channel. See you soon with Fabrizio. Ciao!